Hi everyone, I'm Tom Slivick and welcome to TSPN for today. Let's take a look at our headlines. Rand Huggett was recognized by the Western Fairs Association recently for creating his 29th consecutive Amador County Fair poster barn in the USA. Amador Supervisors discuss voluntary design and agricultural guidelines for a future general plan workshop. Ione Business and Community Association Mixer include a tour of the newly remodeled Ione Public Library done with local business and community efforts. Fire restrictions were activated this week on all BLM-managed public lands in the Mother Lode District, including Amador County. And Jackson Rancheria to host pay-per-view UFC 149 Saturday in its Grand Oak Ballroom. In the second half of the news, I'll be speaking with Amador County CEO Troy Byers about the 2012 fair barn in the USA. Stay with us. We'll have these stories when I come back from the other side of the break. You're watching Amador County's number one news and sports leader, TSPN. Hi everyone and welcome back. Amador High School art teacher and artist Rand Huggett was honored by the Western Fairs Association recently for his 30 years work with the Amador County Fair, including the last 29 consecutive years as its poster artist. Huggett said it's been a good gig creating the poster and the cover for the fair guide. He was honored for his latest poster promoting 2012's barn in the USA, and he's won 10 blue ribbons for his annual posters over the years from the Western Fairs Association. The special award this year was framed Blue Ribbon Award, given in recognition and appreciation of dedication, support to the Amador County Fair. He said the award was a surprise. Huggett showed some of his posters to TSPN TV this week, along with one that was not his from 1982, the last time someone other than Huggett designed and created the poster. Huggett said some of his simpler works have gotten the top WSA ribbons, while some, including the Mardi Gras theme, he put a lot of time and work and expected a top prize, but did not get it. It was basically up to the judges' opinions any particular year. And the award from Western Fairs Association was recognition for Huggett's first 10 Blue Place Ribbon Awards from WFA, which represent all Western Fairs, including the Calgary Stampede and the California State Fair at Cal Expo. Huggett has been creating award-winning posters for the Amador County Fair for 29 years. He worked for the fair as a publicist for 5 years and first created the poster in 1983. He said the fair board liked it, and from then on, he was given the position. When he retired as a publicist in 1988, he remained the poster artist, and the posters bear his style and reoccurring theme was the miner from the very first poster, who reoccurs in other posters, including this year's Barn in the USA. Huggett said he made the miner younger this year, and milestone posters included the 150th sesquicentennial anniversary of the founding of Amador County in 2004, and 24 years ago, the 50th anniversary of the Amador County Fair. The Fair Board congratulated Huggett and said it can't wait for his 30th year and the 2013 poster marking the 75th anniversary edition of the Amador County Fair. Huggett said he's not sure how much longer he will be doing the posters. And the process includes taking the Fair Board's theme and converting it into 8 or 9 mock-up posters. These are then considered by the Fair Board, sometimes adding other ideas and other times leaving them with the simple central ideas. The theme then becomes part of some of the fair exhibitors' themes, as in this year's barn in the USA. The 74th edition of the Amador County Fair starts Thursday, July 26. Supervisors in late June discussed revising the draft county general plan to have voluntary design and architectural guidelines. Amador County Planning Director Susan Grijalva said the county does not have development or architectural design standards, and supervisors agreed making standards mandatory was not a good idea. Supervisor John Plass said one of the longest detrimental effects on development is the lack of guidance by the county. He suggested a workshop on the draft general plan design element in its entirety to see what they do and what they do not want. Public comment: Lynn Morgan, chair of the Upcountry Community Council, said her board would meet in early July to come up with a consensus among citizens and business owners for what they want in the Buckhorn Town Center. She supported voluntary, not mandatory, standards and guidelines. Mike Bennett at Pine Grove said the main hindrance to development was extra fees. He urged having a planning commission design review process and delaying the process until an
environmental impact report was completed for the general plan. Karen Nilsson of the Mother Lode Tea Party said decisions have consequences that are sometimes unforeseen and urged supervisors to try to eliminate some bad things. Leroy Carlin said public outcry about the Martell McDonald's remodel led to a compromised building, but asked, what the hell difference did it make? He said the owner has $12,000 in property tax invested in the property, and his time was wasted by complaints from people who did not have 10 cents invested in the property. Carlin said they are paying staff to spend time recording meetings about McDonald's colors next door to a car dealership that has every color in the book. He said such scrutiny of projects is why people are moving out of California. Grijalva said, we do not routinely get four different designs from developers. When Lowe's came in, they brought us their building permit. She said the planning department was able to uphold the Amador Ridge Shopping Center's architectural master plan. The motif was mission style with heavy timbers, and we were able to ask for more. She said the county does not have architectural design standards, but when developers inquire, she could hand them the staff report and say, this was the direction the board was going to go. Supervisors decided to go through the decision elements one by one to pick and choose what they want to keep as voluntary design and architectural guidelines. They moved to set the workshop session in a 1:30 p.m. time slot after a future board meeting. The date was not set because of low priority and short planning department staffing. Grijalva said when they have time, they will notify the supervisors who would set a workshop. Ione Business and Community Association hosted its monthly mixer with a tour and ceremonial grand reopening to show off local efforts to remodel the Ione Public Library Thursday, July 19th. The Native Sons of the Golden West, in conjunction with the Ione Rotary, invited the public to attend the monthly IBCA mixer Thursday, July 19th in the Native Sons Hall on Main Street in Ione, with organizers saying that attending the monthly mixer gave people a chance to walk next door to view the newly remodeled Ione Library. The 150-year-old library had needed a facelift for many years, so Ione Rotary members organized the project. Volunteers dedicated hundreds of hours to remove everything to the bare walls and beyond. The building now has all new wiring, sheetrock, flooring, paint, and shelving, as well as a brand new restroom. The project, in excess of $20,000 in cost, would not have been possible without generous donations from the Ione Rotary, the Friends of the Amador County Library, the Native Sons of the Golden West, and local philanthropists. The IBCA has an open-door policy regarding board meetings, which are always held on the third Thursday of each month at 8:30 a.m. at the Castle Oaks Golf Club. Anyone is welcome to attend, and ideas and comments will always be. The Bureau of Land Management Central District announced the initiation of fire restrictions on BLM lands effective this week in 11 counties of the Mother Lode Field District, including Amador County. BLM Mother Lode Office Public Information Officer David Christie announced the restrictions were effective Tuesday, July 17th. Christie said BLM is implementing fire restrictions on all BLM-managed public lands within the Mother Lode Field Office boundary. This includes BLM-managed public lands in Amador, El Dorado, Calaveras, Mariposa, Nevada, Placer, Sacramento, Stanislaus, Sutter, Tuolumne, and Yuba counties, a total of about 230,000 acres. The fire restrictions will remain in effect until further notice, BLM Fire Management Officer Gerald Martinez said. The restrictions prohibit all open fires on public lands because of extremely dry conditions, and with the recent high temperature, fuels are extremely dry. Campers are urged to be familiar with special limitations prior to visiting any public lands in the Mother Lode counties. A valid campfire permit is required for all fires. Campfire permits are available free of charge at any BLM Forest Service or California Department of Forestry office, but campers need to be aware of restrictions in the area they are visiting. The restrictions, effective Tuesday, include no open fires, campfires, or open fire stoves, except lanterns and portable stoves using gel, gas, petroleum, or pressurized liquid fuel. No welding or use of any torch with an open flame except by special permit. Restrictions include no use of explosives except by special permit, no operating internal combustion engines except on maintained roads, no firing tracers or incendiary devices capable of starting a fire, and no fireworks. Violations are punishable by fines up to $1,000 and or imprisonment for up to 1 year in jail. For additional information, contact BLM's Mother Lode Field Offices at 916-941-31. The Jackson Rancheria Casino Report on Saturday, July 21st, will host the latest mixed martial arts pay-per-view fight with the Ultimate Fighting Championship Fight 149 to be aired on screens in the Grand Oak Ballroom at the hotel at 7 p.m. Doors open at 6 p.m. Pub-style snacks and ice cold beer will be available for purchase. Patrons must be 21 to attend. Tickets are $10. Available at the casino cage or online at jacksoncasino.com. The main card features Faber versus Barrow, Lombard versus Bartech, and Clements versus Riddle. Prelims include McGee, Ring, Delorme versus Riviera, Jamiro versus Parash, Carway versus Gagnon, Calavero versus Pignet, and Clark versus Covian. The fight card may change at some time, and some fights may not be broadcast. Check UFC.com for the latest details. The UFC uses unified rules of mixed martial arts without exception and holds more than 20 fights per year, hosting most of the top-ranked fighters in the world. Events are held not only in America, but in 149 countries around the globe. Watch the UFC 149 Rancheria style with your friends at the Jackson Rancheria Casino Resort at New York Ranch Road on Jackson. When I come back, we'll be talking to Troy Bauer. And the weather? Well, it's hot out there.
You're watching Amador County's number one news and sports leader, TSPN.